السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Fahad Alamtiri from STC. And today we are having this session which mainly focus on the key business imperatives. And also we are going to figure out the strategic trends that are affecting the telecom industry as well as STC, let's say in general. We are actually hoping, and inshallah, this session will perhaps give us information and will put us in the right path actually on going to the future, inshallah, for all the telecom industry. Now I'm handing over to Mr. Dan Piller, who is a principal analyst from Forrester. He is gonna, inshallah, share with us this information in this session, bi-idhnillah. So Mr. Dan, you have the microphone to start the presentation.
So much. It's a pleasure being here today with you and to share some of the insights that we have regarding the telecom trends and also the trends that impact the enterprise customers of the telcos. Good point where to start our session today is to look at the enterprise customer knowledge priorities. And here we see that security and privacy related themes have really shot up over the last few years to dominate the list of priorities for the enterprise customers. Not surprisingly, if you think about remote working, hybrid working, also the increasing role of e-commerce, this explains a lot why security and privacy is so important, in addition, of course, to the spread of connected solution. Thirdly, we see a much greater focus on the need to have reliable and resilient IT and networking solutions. And we also see that the delivery speed of IT and network solutions is an absolute top priority. If we now look at the kind of drivers that impact the decisions, what to purchase and what to upgrade in terms of the networking, we see that the need to expand, to move into the cloud environment and embrace cloud platforms is at the top of priorities. We also see that there is increasing focus on expanding Internet of Things type of solutions. This has gone up quite significantly as well over the last few years. And then in terms of the security, cybersecurity dynamics, we see that the realization of implementing the zero trust approach to security has really also gone up quite significantly in the last few years. Well, if we zoom in to the issue of 5G, more specifically, we see that about three quarters of businesses say that they are actually increasing their spending on 5G. And this is a clear indication that the dynamics around 5G are gaining momentum. This willingness to spend and invest in 5G is much higher than what we have seen in the past. Again, the need to upgrade the network infrastructure towards more broadband, towards a massive IoT type of solutions, and of course also to move more closely into the very low latency environment are key drivers here. Well, if we zoom into one specific area of 5G, that is the private 5G space, we see that the interest in working together with telcos remains very high, 47%. So one in two enterprise customers would work with the carrier to implement private 5G, but we also see that there is quite a large segment of enterprise customers could imagine to working with the network infrastructure vendors or IT service organizations. So ultimately, we believe this means that there will be a kind of an ecosystem approach to how you need to plan your private 5G environments between the carriers, between the network equipment vendors, and also the IT service organizations. But overall, private 5G, as well as private 4G, I should add here, are important topics for enterprise customers. Now, IoT, I already mentioned as an important trend. And if we look at the kind of sectors, the industries that are most interested in IoT solutions, we see that it is the utility space, it is business services and construction, it is retail and wholesale, and also manufacturing. And then it drops off somewhat, but I would still caution against picking out one particular sector as being most advanced in the IoT space. We see very interesting, impressive solutions right across the board, from mining to transport and logistics. It very much depends really on the tech leadership of a particular business that affects and impacts the state of IoT type of solutions. Edge networking is another important topic that we should really look at. If you like the other side of the coin in terms of the 5G developments, with 5G being one side of the coin and edge networking is the other side of the coin. And here we see that a very high percentage of firms, roughly 85% of firms, are expressing their desire to invest and increase their spending on edge networking. And again, the key drivers here are the desire to ensure that the broadband availability is there, that the round trips of data traffic is kept to a minimum. And so we see a clear interest in edge networking and edge computing overall that is impacting the enterprise customers and therefore also the carrier world. Well, let's zoom into the issue of development of network infrastructure. And here we see that the network infrastructure priorities really reflect the need to build the more differentiated connectivity solutions for enterprise customers that we have looked at. And above all, the main interest seems to focus on the concept of moving more into the managed services space, if you like, and also embracing the concept of as a service for the network. So network as a service cloud versions are at the top of the plans to adopt particular network and telecoms technologies, followed by business-wide networking fabrics, and also the whole issue around network automation, self-healing networks, the virtualization, the software-defined networking trend are absolutely critical for enterprise customers. But in particular, it is the network as a service dynamic that we have seen that plays a much bigger role. And therefore, let's look at some of the key benefits of the network as a service trend. Here we see that a key benefit is that you don't need to own network yourself. It's an integrated network solution where you have the hardware, the software, and the services combined. Therefore, arguably, it becomes less complex for the enterprise customer and also faster to deploy. It's an end-to-end managed and orchestrated offering. So again, it's much more efficient and easy for the enterprise customer to use. You can scale the solution up and down. And there are different type of payment models, if you like, subscription models, but also the possibility of paying on demand is there. And so overall, the benefit of having this approach means that there's also greater efficiency. Arguably, there are implications for the cybersecurity dynamics because you have constant updates of the cybersecurity solutions that go with network as a service. And last but not least, we see that there is a lower dependency on having the expert talent in-house because it is a managed solution, if you like. Now, cloud is clearly a very important driver for network as a service, and we see that there is a big shift from the physical to virtual machines and to cloud-native platforms that is driving the overall virtualization of network functionality. And this, in turn allows the carriers to dynamically share the spectrum and network functionality. The automation and the orchestration means that there is a much greater efficiency of the software architecture and the systems that the carriers can use and that they can make available to their enterprise clients. And we see that cloud-native applications really therefore also require a different approach to the network infrastructure architecture. They must be independent of the underlying network infrastructure. And the dynamics around cloud are also applying to the radio access network, which is a fairly recent trend, but we do see that cloud is actually also entering the core network component. Now, security pops up over and over again as a key theme. And this is not entirely surprising because we see more and more connected solutions, whether it's the connected automotive car, whether it is the utilities, whether it's the smart factory. In healthcare, we see more and more connected devices. Even in government, we see a big drive towards the smart municipalities and smart cities. So the attack surface is growing as more and more assets get connected, and also, of course, as more and more people are using more and more devices. And this implies that you need to really think about the protection of the data that is being generated, that is transported, that is stored, and that is also analyzed. And so we see a much greater focus on the zero trust approach to cybersecurity. Now, with the cloud becoming much more important, there is also an important trend that affects the carriers themselves. And we see that there is a migration of network components into the public cloud. And we see that the carriers really are intending to make the network and the IT infrastructure more service interested, oriented, and that it is also a cost factor, of course, to make the cost base more flexible. We also see that the network equipment vendors are developing their own cloud offerings. And this is a trend that has been ongoing for some time. But what is relatively new is that the public cloud providers play an ever more important role in actually providing network service provisioning. And this means that there are more and more vendors involved, and this multi-vendor environment invariably also raises the interoperability issues, and they in turn affect the quality of service and service level agreements that the carriers can offer to their customers and that they have to tackle somehow. So the virtualization of the providers of their networks is overall helping to minimize the integration complexities. These are players like VMware and similar players that are helping to manage this virtualization of the network infrastructure transformation process. And we also see as a result that a whole new generation of carriers is emerging that are really cloud-based. And this is a trend that we believe will actually accelerate in the coming years. It also means that the relationship between the carriers and the hyperscalers is changing, it's transforming. And there's nothing inevitable about this process, but the relationship with hyperscalers and the carriers, it will be redefined by the cloud, of the cloudification of the network. And this means that there is potentially also a risk for the carriers' value propositions and, you know, the way how carriers should propose their role, their value add to their enterprise customers. And the hyperscalers, they are beginning to deploy public cloud infrastructure inside the core and the radio access networks, in addition to what they have done for some time now, where they have deployed their cloud-based solutions in the OSS and BSS space. But what is relatively new is that they're pushing deeper and deeper into the core and into the radio access network space. And the hyperscalers also need to be careful, of course, not to abuse the increasingly powerful position, because if it contradicts and overlaps too much with the carrier value proposition, there is an increasing risk of competition growing between these two parties. And in addition, we see that the regulators might also be more involved in terms of providing a regulatory framework for what can be done in the sense of hyperscalers providing the network infrastructure from a national security perspective. Last but a very important trend relates to the growing ecosystem partnerships and alliances between the carriers themselves. And here I'd like to highlight one interesting example that was launched during the Mobile World Congress in Barcelona this year, and it's the GSMA Open Gateway Initiative. This is a platform for software as a service providers in particular. So SaaS players will benefit from this. It's a framework of common network APIs, and it provides a universal access to operator networks for the developers of the SaaS solutions. So it, the goal here is to help developers and cloud providers to enhance and to deploy the services more quickly and do this across the carrier networks that are part of this initiative, which, by the way, are at this stage 21 carriers with a total customer base of roughly 2.5 billion users. The goal is to deliver services consistently across the carrier networks in an API world. And also worth pointing out here is that the initial focus is on elements like SIM swaps and quality, demand, number and location verification, and also edge side routing. There will be more to come, of course. The initiative was just launched, but it's a very interesting push in the direction where we see that carriers are coming together to provide a more consistent user experience for their enterprise customer base. And in addition, of course, to their consumer base ultimately as well. To summarize the key high-level trends and what they mean for the carrier world, I'd like to focus on four elements. Firstly, the value propositions. Here we believe that it's absolutely important for carriers to translate the benefits that their connectivity solutions can deliver to specific business objectives that their enterprise customers have. So make the link between connectivity and business benefits that the connectivity can support. Secondly, in terms of the offerings, we see that there will be a much greater push into cloud environments, between cloud environments, and also the cloudification of the service components. And in addition, we believe that flexible working solutions, remote hybrid working solutions, will be a very important part of the future carrier portfolio. And we also see that agile interconnection, similar to what we have seen with the effort around the GSMA Open Gateway Initiative, will play a very important role. Thirdly, the go-to-market approach should definitely use language of target stakeholders. This means that it's not just aimed at network professionals and engineers, but carriers need to also formulate the benefits that connectivity can deliver for departments like marketing, product development, research and development, those stakeholders that are not part of the tech team per se. And in addition, we see that there's a much greater demand for more flexible pricing options, for instance, on-demand pricing. So scaling like network as a service will play an important role here. And last but not least, in terms of innovation, we see that carriers are coming together more and more to build partner ecosystems. They also build partner ecosystems with the network equipment vendors and industry-specific providers, software houses, hardware houses. Look at ecosystems like the 5GAA or the 5GA CIA. They are specific ecosystems aimed at sectors like automotive and manufacturing in this case. And also, we see there's a much greater willingness and need to take customer feedback on board and implement it in an agile fashion. So to embrace iterative and open innovation to ensure that the customer experience will be the right one for the carrier enterprise customer. With this, I'd like to thank you. It's a high level and fast overview over the key trends, but we believe these key trends are really important for the carrier dynamics and carrier developments in the coming years. Thank you very much.
Many thanks, Mr. Dan, for delivering this information, even though if it was high-level, let's say, notes or points, but we are pretty sure that this will enhance, actually, or let's say, open many thinking areas of us in the telecom industry. Thank you so much, Dan. Okay, now we can finish the recording, Tosif. We'll cut the last part, of course, at the end.